Paul, I've got to ask you about the auto action survey where you were voted the dirtiest driver on the paddock. How do you feel about that?
Oh, I'll probably have to go have a shower. But no, it's great. I love it. I'm proud of it. And the fans have reacted in the right way. They're right behind me. So I reckon all the other guys are a bunch of pussies, so it's good.
All right, mate. Keep it clean. Keep it dirty.
Then as he dropped off the jacks. Still cranking it.
This thing won't go, you cunts. Come on.
Here we go. And it's Paul Morris and Jamie Wincup getting together.
On replay. That's pretty nasty.
Oh!
Just locked in. He goes off into that ditch, sideways at pace.
Must have tangled wheels and the thing just lifted up and went across the top of him. And when it landed, I sort of grabbed a gear and kept going. I couldn't believe it.
Do you think that Richie will see it as just a racing accident?
No, he'll probably say it's my fault, but we'll see what happens.
I think it comes back to the individual setups, Daryl. Almost a touch there. Longhurst, he really got sideways. This is the last week because they're running out laps. Oh, no, 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 no. They've hit, and oh, that's a big shot, let me tell you. Longhurst tried. Oh, he's not happy either, Longhurst. He gets out of the car. I can't believe this. They're teammates, these two. Oh, no, he's put the Biffo back into the Bingle.
Conville buys in here. Oh, someone's buried
in deep.
Oh, that's
a big one from Paul Morris.
The top of frame there, you'll see that he would have been behind Bradley and in front of Glenn, I think, on the way down in the into seven. Now, whether there's been any helping hand, I don't know. But he's gone in sideways and the sand has grabbed the car. And it's, more chaos up here. Holy smoke.
And that's Todd Kelly has slammed into the rear of Paul Morris.
No, we knew the boards were out, but Garth and all the guys in front were pressing on. If you slow down, you just lose pit position. And all the cars are falling out of pit lane, so...
And a little bit of contact between the brothers Kelly here. Both Todd and Rick were banging doors down at turn one. So, oh, speaking of banging doors, this time Paul Morris on Todd Kelly. As we watch more of the chaos here, it's Kelly and Paul Morris, and it's a bit of push and shove. And between those guys at the moment, it's getting ugly. Here it is again. Well,
they haven't missed each other this weekend, put it that way.
So, hard under brakes at the end of Flint Place. Into turn 13, Stephen Richards, look at Paul Morris heading along the inside of Perkins.
Perkins!
And he's turned Perkins around.
Oh dear.
Well, we could have, and I think, qualifying, we sort of just fell out of the 10, so... it's one of those weekends, anything can happen. I think there's a lot of carnage out there at the moment, so we'll have to sort of survive this one and see how we go.
All right, mate, all the best.
Thank you.
Paul Morris, with Paul Morris. Paul's just seen that for the first time. What do you make of it all?
It just looks like three cars going for the same bit of road, doesn't it?
And turn two, Connor Caban, some big problems coming into that turn. You can see the smoke blowing out.
Whoa!
Nothing but concrete on car.
Now Morris is on Conrod straight and has got a chance to go by and send a little bit of a message as well to the Lancer, and I think that was one more position to me, something
I think
like that.
It might have been, I'm going to pass you at turn one, might have been what he was trying to say, because we have a look on the replay. Yep, turn one, but thanks for letting me by on Conrod anyway.
The fastest man on the road at the moment is actually David Bernard, who's moved up to third, and then Dumbrell runs wide into the kitty litter. So David Bernard has had a pretty good weekend in terms of his recovery, Matthew. Oh, Dumbrell around. And there's more to that story because there's some damage there in the front right corner.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, there's the sure big story. There's a wheel gone loose, and that is Paul Morris's Cirame Wines VY converted car, and it's a real mess. Smoke pouring out the rear, out the front. Let's just hope that Paul Morris is okay.
It's a huge shunt.
That's big time.
Paul's wife there, obviously looking pretty concerned about it. Bradley's had a moment which has then steered him right. It really didn't like the bump at the top of the curbing there, the two of them side by side. And it's flicked into the side of the Cirame entry. Just ridden itself up the wall.
The last race of the day in round 9 of the Shell Series. 10
Yes,
start, like a bullet out of the gate against Clona.
Morris and Marlowe. Oh, whoa.
Oh, geez, I hope he gets out of that in a hurry.
Yes, he's out of it.
Goodness me.
Well, they'll have to stop it.
This is what happened to Paul Morris, right at the cutting, from side to side.
Such is the slippery condition at the top that it trapped Paul Morris on the run-up to the cutting. Couldn't pull it up. Locked the rears and whacking the wall here.
Look at this battle now. Russell Engle's got plenty of speed on board. The Castrol Commodore has a sniff on the inside of Paul Morris. Not quite close enough. Morris wants to fight. They're going to argue as they go down the pit straight, but Paul Morris gets good acceleration out of the turn on the main straight. He moves across to cover his line, and Russell Engle gets his nose shut off.
Yes, got it.
So Engle down the inside of Paul Morris, who's starting to struggle now.
And Scape's going to have a run at him as well. Scape's got a better run off the final corner, and he'll try and crisscross him at the other end. But Morris is awake up, covers his ground well.
Let's have a look again. This was what started it all. Waters down the inside at turn one on Morris, who gets bumped off the road, goes the other side of the Marshall's post. This compressed them up because it gave Jacobson the big chance to get them both down the inside. As it turned out, he did get them both, but not without a bit of drama behind it in front.
That's right. Then Morris comes back after Jacobson, and Waters have a little touch there. Puts his nose up the inside.
And that's the return of serve from the one at turn one.
So Morris is allowed to return to the circuit at turn eight. No problem with that. But he has gained an advantage.
Yep.
So he's ahead of Jacobson. He has to actually pull back.
Let's have a look on the Shell Helix replay, Bates.
That's Paul Morris. What's going on here? A little bit of a touch. Oh, yeah, it's Morris at the inside of Ellery. Can't really say it was anyone's fault. But
quite clearly into this hairpin, it'd be quite easy to overtake. But as you can see, the cars are actually fairly even. So Morris and Glenn Seaton.
Yeah, that was on for a while. Paul was just sliding in for 100 metres or so there, and he couldn't pull it up on the inside of the road, and he's given Glenn a tap. So it was as if it wasn't tough enough for Seaton after making contact with the wall down there at turn 14. He's now off the edge of the road, and Paul Morris has got a pile of damage on the front of the Sirame entry.
Damage on the front of the tall Commodore as well.
It's been a bit chaotic, this one, hasn't it?
So just look for this. Right in the middle of your screen is David Bernard, and Bernard is the one, but with some assistance from Paul Morris. So Paul Morris was down the left-hand side of Bernard. Take a look to your left. That's Paul Morris. Left-hand screen, the black VIP Falcon. There they go. They come across. There's bumping. That's what Neil said. There's no road down there. Bang. Morris into Bernard, into Richards, off the road.
We'll see Todd Kelly on the Zinger replay getting wide at turn four, and the victim is Owen Kelly, the Team Sirame car.
Not sure, it might be Paul Morris. Can't pick up the numbers.
Here's the Shell Helix replay. Watch this. As Lowndes goes through on the inside.
Oh, well, that was where we were talking about.
He was right where you were talking about, Barry, and he ended up out of the wheel tracks. That was the problem there. And on that surface to the outside, the car just takes off, and he was a passenger.
Trouble here between Paul Morris and Jason Richards. Whoa!
Oh.
Exactly the same problem. Straight up and over that ripple strip, which has been questioned by many of the senior drivers. And this is the one that happened just moments ago. And Jason Richards, just monumental damage to the front and back of the car.
Morris does not want to come in and serve this penalty. Not a great deal he can do about it at present, Neil.
No.
There he is.
You can argue about it all day long. They've issued an instruction, and that's it.
That's the most bullshit thing I've ever seen in my life.
Well, there you have it. And this will be interesting. Cast your mind back to Bathurst some years ago with a pretty fired-up Greg Murphy. He served a five-minute penalty. They stood still for 5 minutes. Morris will be stopped here for 60 seconds.
So
a lifetime.
When it gets to about 50 seconds, then you start it, okay?
Hey. Siprinic there to the right. Very talented engineer who's worked over the years with BMW in sports cars and in super touring, and for a time there was with the Stone Brothers outfit, now very much a part of Paul Morris Motorsport and has been for many years. An eternity for Paul Morris.
So that extra message that came across to Paul Morris there was from someone that had been down to this building where the stewards and the IPO are, the investigating and prosecuting officer, and they confirmed that they've looked at it, they've made their decision, it's not debatable.